Hey everybody, thanks so much for joining this video about the top 5 DevSecOps tools in 2022. And if you like me, you're probably out being chased by DevSecOps vendor trying to sell you their tools. And you want to know what are the tools that will give you the most return on investment for your organization. If that's it, you should listen to this video. All right, so if you don't know me, I'm Nick Chenon, the former Chief Software Officer for the Air Force and Space Force, and we brought DevSecOps to the entire Department of Defense. So if we could do it for the largest organization on the planet, you can do it too, whether you're in finance, healthcare, retail, doesn't matter. You can make it happen, and you can take a look at some of my favorite tools. And for full disclosure, I am sitting on the board of some of these companies, but no one is paying me to make this video, and no one can buy my thoughts. So clearly, this is what I believe. If I join the board of some of these companies, it's because I believe in the companies and the people behind it. So let's take a look. So the first tool in the list is obviously going after the foundation of DevSecOps. And you would not have DevSecOps without a CI/CD pipeline, continuous integration, continuous delivery pipeline, but also a Git repository, because the source of truth of your code is in Git. Git is your source of truth. It's your crown jewel. So you need a Git repo and you need a CI/CD pipeline. And what better than the GitLab DevOps platform to bring you a turnkey end-to-end capability that includes first the source code side of the house, but also the CI/CD pipeline as well. Although I only recommend using GitLab on the CI side. We'll be talking a little bit about the continuous delivery side using GitOps, which is a very different principle that we're going to be covering right after GitLab. All right, so to do that, we're going to be taking a look at the GitLab website where they show the full DevOps lifecycle. They cover every phases of the stack, but we're not going to be using GitLab so much on the continuous delivery side, but they do, of course, a great job when it comes to the Git repo, the management, the planning, the security scanning, SAS and DAST, and of course, all the project planning and management of projects. So if you take a look at their website, you're gonna see why. Obviously, they do a pretty good job. Of course, a lot of people complain that GitLab is very holistic and provides a lot of the end-to-end DevOps capabilities, which often means you get a lot of different things, but you don't get a lot of depth when it comes to each feature. So you're gonna see feature gaps, but we know that the GitLab team is working on fixing a lot of these gaps as well. So for a single price point, you get probably the most comprehensive return on investment when it comes to DevSecOps. It's of course going to be hosting your crown jewel, the source code side of the house. That's your crown jewel in GitOps. So that brings up to the second product with Weaveworks Flux. And Weaveworks has been leading when it comes to GitOps for so many years now, with the contribution to the Cloud Native Computing Foundation, CNCF, of Flux. Flux brings you an end-to-end orchestration, continuous delivery capability using GitOps, using a pull from Git continuously multiple times a day, and enables you to deploy in production and staging, of course, and kind of streamlined that continuous deployment of capability. And it really enables you to go back to immutable state and go back to that cattle mindset of everything is in Git. Your source code is your source of truth. And that's where you're going to pull from. And that enables that continuous delivery aspect of DevSecOps using, of course, best of breed open source capabilities. So that's number two. Let's look at number three. So let's look at Encore. Encore is a pretty well-known capability. It enables, of course, container scanning. That's what most people know Encore from. But also, Encore is able to bring a full software bill of material supply chain management. And that's a massive enabler, particularly more recently, thanks to the President's Cyber Executive Order, which pushes federal agencies to adopt software bill of material best practices. So we know dependencies and what's inside of the software we consume. That's obviously very important, particularly due to the recent breaches we've seen across the world. So Encore has two very well-known open source tools. The first one is Stiff, and Stiff is a CLI tool that can generate comprehensive software bill of material for from container images and file systems. So that's going to be on the SBOM side of the house. And Gripe is a vulnerability scanner that combines with Sift and can find vulnerabilities in all major operating systems and even inside of language-specific packages. So that's also pretty unique. And so if you combine both, you get a full SBOM package with both dependencies and the full list of vulnerabilities as well. So that's the product number three. Now let's look at the fourth product, and that's of course Istio with the service mesh. And Istio is very well known from the open source community, brings a full scale service mesh using Envoy as a reverse proxy. There is a main company as well behind it with Tetrate and their Tetrate service bridge. And what you're going to find there is a pretty game-changing capability when it comes to moving to microservices. Moving from legacy to microservices, of course, is what we aim to do. And that creates a lot of complexity when it comes to traffic and understanding the east-west lateral movements, what's normal, what's potential malicious behavior. So if you're going to take a look here, you're going to see some of the my favorite feature ready, where you can see that traffic in real time and visually see the east-west traffic, but also your ingress-egress in real time, including your load balancing and so on. So that gives you not only real-time visibility of your current state, but also gives you the ability to track that traffic and enables the abstraction across clusters, federation of clusters, management of those meshes across multi-tenant, and of course do that across multiple cluster and integrates that lifecycle management. That's a pretty complex thing to do, and most people that just get started in Kubernetes don't understand yet the importance of a service mesh. But I can tell you have no chance of success in 2022 to get where you want to be if you do not have access to a service mesh. So the service mesh is a massive enabler. It's going to streamline the ability for teams to release software. I'm not going to be able to here cover really what a service mesh is, but that gives me the opportunity to tell you also about the Tetrate Academy, where you can go and get access to awesome training, both the Istio and Envoy fundamentals, but also the first certified Istio administrator to be able to get your people or yourself certified in Istio. So that's something you want to pay attention to. That's probably one of the most game-changing skills you can acquire. So very rare and very well paid in industry right now. So that's my fourth product, most favorite product now with Tetrate. All right, so now let's look at the fifth favorite DevSecOps product of 2022 with Traceable AI that enables tracing and API security. And really, this is a very comprehensive capability. I like it because it piggybacks back on top of the service mesh, but also enables additional security capabilities on top. So it's going to give you full visibility of your APIs all the way to, of course, the layer 7, but also give you a behavior AI ML driven prevention protection capabilities and analytics, also detecting rogue APIs, detecting potential fraudulent use of your APIs, or maybe some of your customers are abusing of your API services. So you want to be able to track that. But it's really also giving you insights and enabling you to label data down to the cell level, where you can have sensitive data and be able to track that and have that risk monitoring ability. Very important, of course, in the government, but also when it comes to PHI, PII, PCI, and so on. So it's really a massive enabler, both on the cyber side, but also when it comes to the development side to detect errors and crashes of APIs, particularly when you have multiple microservices talking to each other. That's a very complex thing that you have to manage with your teams. Particularly due to the decoupling of teams, you want to make sure you find what are the dependencies and potential bottlenecks and be able to react to cyber issues very rapidly. All right, that was the top five DevSecOps tools for 2022. If I missed the tools, if you have different favorite tools, please put it into the comment section below. Also, please subscribe to this new channel on YouTube / Nicholas Schiller. Also, if you would like to get notification for our videos, please subscribe to our mailing list. The mailing list is accessible at inthenickoftime.tv. Thanks so much for joining and stay tuned for the next video.